Yo, it's Mel from Rap Rankings. To hear the full episode this clip comes from and all the other episodes, stop by raprankings.com or search Rap Rankings on your favorite podcast platform.
Track 6, Pick It Up, produced by Eric Sermon.
Let's pick it up.
7-.
We know.
Flat 8. Jamie right. Baby.
8+.
Wow, all right.
I got the sample here, Mel.
Okay.
Is that Roger Troutman, So Rough, So Tough?
Never heard it, I don't think. Open it up here. Redman, Archivo, let's pick it up. So Rough, So Tough, Roger Troutman. The vocoder man, right?
Yeah, from Zap and Roger.
All right, here we go.
Play the beat. It's like, get on down.
The get on down. Got it. Okay. Let me play the beat. Because I was about to say, yeah. The bass. Okay. So it wasn't the bass line.
No, the bass line on here sounds like Rising to the Top, but it's not.
It actually sounds like something else to me. I'll tell you after I finish playing the beat. But here it is. Pick it up. Pick it up. Pick it up. Pick it up.
If you find a bag of weed on the floor, motherfucker, what the fuck you gon' do? Pick it up, pick it up,
pick it up, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up, pick it up. Okay, get on, all right, okay, get on now. Yeah, what that bass line actually reminds me of.
Boom, 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 boom.
You're singing it right now. You're right there. It reminds me of OutKast, funking around.
Oh, yeah. Boom, boom, boom. Yeah, wait. Yeah.
That was rap. I'm rap, you know? I try.
It's not rap, I'm rap.
No, brother, you ain't rap king. Okay. Here we go.
Hello. Well, good evening, ladies and gentlemen. What we like to do right here, well, first of all, let me let you know who I am. Well, I go by the name of Andre 3000, right? And we're here from a little place called, like, Stankonia, Georgia, right? You know, right now, everybody wants to be from space and, like, wants to be from the country and everything like that. You know, like, really, like, the South is, like, cool to be from the South right about now. Girls, listen up. Between Saturday night and early Sunday morning, I don't know, I'm somewhere stuck in between tween. I'm out here knowing hip hop is dead. The average nigga on my corner yelling, what the fuck you mean?
Boom, boom, you know?
Boom, 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 boom. That's a time, by the way.
I don't know if I've heard that.
It's hey, on the Jesse? Big Boy and Dre are OutKast, the greatest hits album that came out
in 2001, I think.
Or yeah, maybe it was after. After Stankonia, before Speakerbox Love Below, it has Movin' Cool, the After Party on it, and this.
I've heard some of that then. Is that the whole world Land of a Million Drums from Scooby-Doo?
Yes, it's on there. Well, no, Whole World is on there. That was the single from the... I used to, when I was a kid, I thought Whole World was on Stankonia, but it's on this Greatest Hits.
Right, so I've heard that at least once.
Funkin' Around is... something that I guess was made after Stankonia, but before Speakerbox Love Below, and they just put it on there. It's track 2 on that album after the intro. It might be my favorite OutKast song. We're never going to be able to actually review it on the show because we don't do greatest hits.
Of all their songs?
Yeah, it really might be.
It's a great song.
Like, you have to listen to it. Like, it has everything about an Outkast song that I love.
Right. Yeah, I didn't discover this song, Jesse, until I
think Sleepy Brown is on there. You just haven't heard him yet.
Sleepy. You know? Yeah.
You've got, like, the whole, like, you've got this whole, like, brass section on there that you haven't heard. Yep. We are just funkin' around.
I've heard that song at least once. So Jesse ain't rap moment. The I ain't having that sample was actually from this song. My bad. We already played the sample.
Oh, shit. Well,
it's all good.
It's all good. It's all good.
I've been fighting for my life this week.
If you correct the record on the show itself, it's fine. People might be yelling at you in the moment, but they'll come to hear that you corrected yourself. So
I know more about rap than anyone who could try to correct me, except for like Dart Adams.
So I think, listen, I am back deep in the muddy waters once again. No more Rock Wilder. We are back to the Eric Sermon bangers here. Probably my favorite, or at least the stickiest sounding bass line on the album. I love verse one. I love Redacted's be like, ah, he changes style up. Shut the fuck up. You still a dick rider.
Yeah.
I love that. Verse two. You remind me of school on a Sunday, no class, beating all kings down, doing over 70 in a Hyundai, blast. Give him a good reason to open Alcatraz, back. The way he chops up his bars on verse two, I'm a big fan. You know, nobody got the red shook, been a weirdo ever since the doctor said push.
I like that.
And, bro, verse three, you know I'm going up for, you know, Jesse, you had to tell him. You're my friend's favorite restaurant. Drop shit. It's microscopic topic. How I stay more bent than McDonald's arches. Mm. Uptown got the la-la spots and badass hoes with the 5411 Reeboks. But still, I walk around with the grill because Redacted be blinded by this hip-hop shit for real. I ain't having that. I'm clapping shit. Fuck this rapping shit. I cause accidents.
There we go.
And then, you know, at the end of the third verse, the song gets cut off by that radio interference. And we're like skipping through the radio to a different station. And the last like minute of this is what is on the corrected version of the album track list, AKA the back cover of the actual album that only has 20 files on the CD.
Yeah.
The NIN skit on the corrected version of the album. And this is Redacted's in Newark, NIN.
Yeah, niggers in Newark, I can say it. And it's amusing. It's an amusing skit. The voice in it actually reminds me of the producer. Shout out to him. He's a good producer. Illingsworth. And a rapper. He's a good producer and a rapper. He does like skits on Instagram and stuff. It reminded me of the stuff he does. But I like
Redman is one of the best skit men in rap. I mean, for me, De La Soul is always going to be number one. Redman is very possibly number two. And then there's other candidates for sure underneath, but they're like my top two skit men.
Nice. Yeah, the skit man. Well,
I'm sorry, go ahead, man.
No, I was just saying I agree with the skit man thing. But what are you saying?
Did you like that line? You like school on Sunday, no class?
Yeah, why?
Just letting you know you're being a Cosmo supporter.
I knew I recognized that. Fat Albert, right?
Yeah.
Another one of my dad's disembodied phrases. Sometimes he'd be like, NC, no class. He would say it all the time. Yeah.
Yep. That came from Fat Albert.
That Fat Albo, so, you know.
He's supporting it. It's bad faith, Jesse, but you're supporting it, you know. At the time,
those things were pills
in the pills and the drinks.
These things weren't known at the time.
I will say this because I just talked about it in the chat, you know, because somebody had, you see that video of Cameron, like, he was like doing a tap dancing.
Like Mendici's?
It's a fucking 10.
Yeah. It was funny.
But it reminded me of that challenge, you know, from the Cosby Show. And listen, folks, I'm just going to say this. We're going to have to bring the Cosby Show back into the conversation. Because there was much more to that show than just the nasty man. It's not fair to the rest of the cast, okay? We can't erase Lisa Bonet.
It's okay to leave it in the past. Okay?
I mean, listen, I'm not saying we have to consider bringing it back, okay?
Bring Fat Lisa Albert's Rashad. Cartoon back into the conversation.
Oh, brother. Fuck them.
Fat guys. Albert, Different World. Anything without his face.
No, Different World is safe. It's safe. Because, yeah, he just produced that, you know. But
Fat Albert.
They already brought Fat Albert back with Kenan Thompson. And, you know, it didn't do what it needed to do.
Did I? Not a
bad movie. The fiance had it on, like, within the last year.
It was whatever
that party scene was. That song was like, it was like a fucking
I'm not
line.
Talking about the quality of the Fat Albert live action reboot. Just that, you know, it didn't make waves. It didn't reignite the public's thirst for Fat Albert.
it made a profit, Black Adam style. It had a budget of $45 million. Box office, $48.6
million. Oh, fuck
yeah. What was the rap song at the party?
That ain't no box office.
I said okay. Black Adam style. Okay. Yeah. Kyla Pratt was in it. Woo-hoo.
What was the rap song at the party? That shit was like a 9.
Oh, shit. I don't know.
They were outside like partying and there was a rap song that they were performing.
It was probably the intro to the Busta Rhymes ELE2.
Yeah. They were performing that. Pete Rock showed up singing Whose World Is This?
Fat Albert movie party song.
That shit was like, you know, she was watching this like in the last year, and I was like, holy shit, this is a good song. I'm jamming out.
You know, the opposite of usually in these movies, like the party songs are horrible, and they're fake rap songs that you'd never actually hear in real life, is I believe in Mean Girls, Lindsay Lohan goes into a party, and they're listening to the Nori song from Neptune's Clones, and it was the opposite. It's like, no high school parties playing fucking Neptune's Clones album cuts with Nori on them. This is too, not that I don't like it, but it's just too good to be real.
Right.
The music supervisor snapped in a bad way. You know, it's like,
it's not like believable.
The music, right. Yeah, you had good taste as a music supervisor, but you know, nobody was listening to Put 'Em Up from the Clones album.
I put it in the chat, Mel.
What you put in the chat? The song?
The Fat Albert scene. You can fast forward a little bit.
Oh, no.
It's like some Nickelodeon shit, but it's quality.
Nickelodeon shit, yeah. Huh? Yeah.
Fast forward a little bit. Okay. Fast forward a little bit.
All right, the verse starts at like 1:10, Mel.
Okay.
Maybe it was a hook I was popping for. Maybe you were high watching it.
Yeah, I was just about to say you were high popping. Style, weren't you? High style for sure.
But I was popping.
Jesse was high, y'all. Okay.
Hey, maybe. I don't remember.
Jesse was an extra.
No, this hook is still hard. I'm listening now. Hey, yo.
Jesse was an extra in the crowd talking about,
yo, that's that nigga, you know what I'm saying?
I was not there.
Alright. I gotta fan myself. Alright.
Jesse, you got anything else for the song here?
Pick it up, yes. When he says back in the day when that other squad was kicking, he was referring to when EPMD, you know, they were all kind of EPMD offspring. So some people went with Eric Sermon, some people went with Parrish Smith. We saying, listen, must we forget I originated all that wild shit? That was kind of like the Dame and Jay breakup of my generation. Yeah, like when they split up, it was a big deal. And then I just had a memory of, like, right after this album came out, a car drove past. I was, like, maybe going to the corner store or something. It was dark outside. Our car drove past, and I just heard the line, Uptown got the La La Spots. And I was like, okay, the new Redman album is out. I'm going to have to go get that soon. And then, let's see. Oh, Archival in the Folder. The sound bed from NIN was from the last Redman album, a song called Neurotic. And it says, well, I'm just saying this was the birth of like violent Newark skits, was like this NIN skit. And that became like a thing on Redman albums. But yeah, you can play the drop that says NIN. The sound bed was from the last Redman album, the one that came before this.
Okay, I see.
Yeah, so that was like a callback to the last album.
Got it.
When they use that. And that was all I had.
All right. Well, y'all want to keep going?
Yep. Yeah. After you pick it up, what do?
You smoke it. Right, right. Oh, sure. That's okay. Transition style. Here we go.
Yo, it's Mel from Rap Rankings. To hear the full episode this clip comes from and all the other episodes, stop by RapRankings.com or search Rap Rankings on your favorite podcast platform.